Hello students, welcome to biology class. Students, one thing I would like to tell you about: success is not an accident. It's your hard work, it's your perseverance, it's your learning, and it's your studying. And moreover, if you are talking about the success, you should love what you are doing, right students? So we are on the chapter reproductive health, and we are discussing some questions which are important as your NEET is concerned. So I'll give you some 10 questions about the NEET, and I'll explain you the answers as well, right students? First of all, you should know what do you mean by reproductive health. A person should be reproductively healthy if it is reproductively healthy in the terms of, if the reproductive organs are healthy in the terms of their physical, in the physical characteristics, in the emotional characteristics, and in the social characteristics. If a person is healthy, if person is healthy in all those aspects, the person will be considered as a reproductive healthy, reproductive health. Right, and this was a definition which was given by the WHO, that is a World Health Organization, students. Right, as the NEET is concerned, the first of all, the question which I will be taking, the first question is, hysterectomy is a surgical removal of A, uterus, B, prostate gland, C, vas deferens, and D, mammary glands. Right, so students, the question is asking that hysterectomy, it's a surgical procedure. Normally, as a tomy is there, that means it's a surgical procedure, obviously. And we have to tell that hysterectomy is surgical removal of uterus, prostate gland, vas deferentia, or mammary gland, right? So, to talk about in this, if we talk about the uterus, let's come from the last. If we talk about the mammary glands, when the mammary glands are removed, that is called as mammectomy. That is called as mammectomy, students, right? If we talk about the vas deferens, right, that is a duct which is present in the male reproductive system. So when we remove this vas deferens, that is called as vasectomy, right? This is called as vasectomy, right? When the prostate gland is removed, this is called as prostatectomy. Right, students, when you are preparing for the NEET, one thing you need to remember is that suppose you are doing some questions, right, and the question is having four options, right? In those four options, if you know that option is particular, like suppose option is D, right, then you should focus on the rest of the option as well, because there are chances that among those rest of the option, there are chances that these may be asked in the future NEET questions, right? So to talk about, so I have given you this name, that is a prostate gland removal is called as prostatectomy, and the removal of vas deferentia is called as vasectomy, and the mammary gland removal is called as mammectomy, right? Similarly, when we remove uterus, this is called as hysterectomy, right? So the option is A, the correct option is option A, right students? So this was our question number one. Let's talk about the question number two now. Let me first of all remove all this. So, question 2 says, which of the following is not a sexually transmitted disease? Right? Sexually transmitted disease, I think we have studied. We have studied, in fact. Sexually transmitted diseases are those diseases which spreads from the one particular body to another with the help of sexual contact or with the transfer of the body fluids, right? So first we have a syphilis. Syphilis is a type of sexually transmitted disease. So let's revise all these things, that what is a causative agent for syphilis? Causative agent for syphilis is treponema. Pallidum. Right, students? Hope you remember this as well. When we were discussing certain sexually transmitted disease, this was one of them. And I told you as well, at that particular time as well, I have told you that you need to remember the causative agent of this as well. Like that this was a treponema pallidum. So for the general point of view, I'm telling you that you need to remember all those things as well. Right? Next, we have a very common disease. We all know that is AIDS, acquired immunodeficiency syndrome, right? Acquired immunodeficiency syndrome is caused by one virus, and that is called as HIV. Hope students, you know the full form of HIV. That is a human immunovirus. Right, students? Right. Next, we have trichomoniasis. Trichomoniasis is also a sexually transmitted disease, students. If we know, the trichomoniasis is spread by one protozoa, that is Trichomonas vaginalis. Trichomonas vaginalis. Right, students? And just because it's a scientific name, so I have underlined this. Next, we have one more disease, that is encephalitis. Encephalitis is a neurological disorder, right? It is not associated with a sexually transmitted disease, or it doesn't spread with the help of body fluids, right? It can occur because of the certain other viruses as well. They are some HPV. These are associated things. Like, this cannot occur by some particular virus, but these are associated. Like, the person may develop this thing as well, right? So this is not a sexually transmitted disease. So answer will be D, sexually transmitted disease. This is not a sexually transmitted disease. That is an encephalitis, right, students? So this was our question number 2. And correct answer is D. Next we have the question. Student, read this question. Till then, I rub all this. Right. So what we have now, the third question, students. Medical termination of pregnancy, MTP. Yeah, you should know the full form of MTP, that is a medical termination of pregnancy, is considered safe up to how many weeks of pregnancy, right? So basically, the answer is 12, right? According to the Medical Termination of Pregnancy Act, I think my students know about that, know about this, Medical Termination of Pregnancy Act, which came into existence in 1971. This states that when we remove any the embryo from the body of the female, so up to 12 weeks it is safer for the child as well as for the mother, but after the 12 weeks it is not at all safe, right? Next option we have is 18 weeks. Next we have 6 weeks. And another we have is 8 weeks. So correct answer is 12 weeks, right? Now the next question is related to AIDS, and I can see that, and very common topic and very important as well as per the NEET is concerned, right? So what we are discussing, at which stage of HIV infection does one usually show symptoms of AIDS, right? So question says, suppose a person is having HIV infection, right? The question states that a person is having HIV infection. Now we have to know at what particular time the symptom of AIDS will be visible, right? So let's go into detail first of all. AIDS, acquired immunodeficiency syndrome, causative agent, HIV, right? Now, you will ask, or I'll tell you first of all, in the AIDS, the cells which are affected are T helper cells, right? T helper cells are affected, and these T helper cells, they interact with the HIV virus with the help of one receptor, which is called as CD4. I think you all know about this, that is CD4 cell. This is how they interact. And what will happen, this HIV, the RNA genome, they have a two copies of single stranded genome having the reverse transcriptase activity and protease activity. They will enter, or they will, what they do, they enter the whole genome, the whole RNA is entered into the cell or the T helper cell. It will replicate with the help of the host machinery and produce a numerous copy and destroy the T helper cell, which is a major part of the human immune system, right? So, one thing you need to remember that the T helper cells are affected, right? So the option says, when a viral DNA is produced by the reverse transcriptase. Is that so? No, not at all, students. Why? When viral DNA is produced by the reverse transcriptase, normally whenever a RNA is inserted into the genome, RNA is inserted into the cell. Now what will happen? The first RNA is converted into the DNA with the help of enzyme that is called as reverse transcriptase, right? So whenever the first RNA or first DNA is inserted, there will be loss of around 1 or 2 T helper cell. I don't think so. That will be so much that T helper cell, 1 or 2 T helper cell will not cause any kind of symptom. I don't think so that it will be there. Actually, it is not there in this case. When HIV replicates rapidly in the helper T lymphocytes and damages large amount of these. Yes, this could be the reason that when HIV replicates and it will affect the T lymphocyte and damages large amount of this. Yeah, this could be the reason, but actually reason in this case, with the 15 days of the sexual contact with the infected person, this is the reason. And one of the reason in this case could be this. These two are approximately correct, but more correct is this. When the HIV replicates rapidly in the helper T lymphocyte and damages a large number of these. Right? So the correct answer in this case will be B option. Right? Why B option? Because T lymphocytes, the helper T lymphocytes are affected. Now what will happen? There will be no production of antibodies because they help in activation of the B lymphocytes that produces the antibodies. So the correct option is B. T lymphocytes are affected. The whole immune system, whole body immune system will be affected. And this correct option we say is a B. Next we have the next question. So students, next question for today's class is the techniques called gamete intrafallopian transfer is recommended for those females. Now, when we were discussing certain assisted reproductive technologies, we were discussing about GIFT, that was a gamete intrafallopian transfer, right? As the name indicates, gamete intrafallopian transfer. This word is written over here, that is meant by gamete, right? In the gamete intrafallopian transfer, what exactly the case is, the gamete or the female gamete is incorporated into the female vagina, or more precisely, I can say into the fallopian tube, right? Now, let's see examples or the options. Who cannot produce an ovum, right? This could be the reason. Because those female who cannot produce the ovum, in that case, this gamete or the female gamete are inserted into the fallopian tube. Yes, this could be the reason, right? Next point is that who cannot retain the fetus inside the uterus? No, this could not be the reason. If they are inserting the gametes, that means the female can receive or female can produce the baby. That means a female can sustain the baby for the 9 months. So this option is wrong. Next, whose cervical canal is too narrow to allow the passage of sperm? If this could be the reason, there will be no point in transferring the gamete into the fallopian tube, right? So this cannot be the reason for that. Next, who cannot provide suitable environment for the fertilization, right? So this D part also says when fertilization cannot occur, then obviously there is no point in transferring the gamete. Because when gamete will be there, there will be fertilization because sperm will enter into the fallopian tube. When they will enter into the fallopian tube, as fertilization occurs in the fallopian tube. So it is saying that if there is no suitable environment for fertilization, then there is no point in inserting the gamete into the fallopian tube. So the correct answer for the question number 5th is A. Right? Next is a question number 6. So, question says, the permissible use of technique amniocentesis is for. Now, what do you mean by amniocentesis? amniocentesis student, it is that procedure where amniotic fluid is taken out, and that amniotic fluid is around 20 to 30 ml of that fluid is taken out. When that fluid is taken out, now what will happen? That fluid will be having the sub of the fetal cell. Those fetal cell will be cultured, those fetal cell will be stained, and they will be used for the karyotyping, so that we can get to know whether the child is having some kind of genetic disorder. We can get to know the sex of that particular fetus, right? So the permissible use of the technique for amniocentesis is for, right, detecting the sex of an unborn fetus. Yes, this could be the reason, but the question is saying permissible use. Right, it is not actually meant for getting the sex of the fetus. It is not for that. So this could be the reason. If we'll not find any other reason, so we'll tick the option A. Right. Next is for artificial insemination. How we can relate the amniocentesis with the artificial insemination. So students, what do you mean by artificial insemination? Artificial insemination means insertion of the sperm into the human body or into the body of the female. That is an artificial insemination, and this could not be the case. How can you relate the amniocentesis, which is a procedure by which we can do, get to know whether the child is having congenital disease or not? So this is a wrong option, right? Third we have is a transfer of embryo into the uterus of surrogate mother. Transfer of embryo into the uterus of surrogate mother. Student, what do you mean by surrogate mother? First of all, tell me. Surrogate mother is that mother who is not the actual mother but will carry the baby for the 9 months, because actual mother is not able to carry that baby for those 9 months because she is infertile, right? So surrogate mother, transfer of embryo into the uterus of surrogate mother. How can this will be related to the amniocentesis? Right. Next we have is detecting any genetic abnormality. Yes, very appropriate answer, detecting any genetic abnormalities. We can get to know whether the child is having certain kind of congenital disease or the metabolic disorders or not. This is the actual use of amniocentesis. Right, students? So I have incorporated this question only because students don't get confused or don't judge in a very fast manner, right? You must read all the four options, then only take a correct one, right? This could be the reason, right? If this is not there, this could be the reason, but we have to write this because this is the more appropriate, because the question is mentioning permissible use, right, students? So the next question, question number 7. So test tube baby programs employs which of the following techniques? Test tube baby. Test tube baby means the baby is born inside the test tube, right? Suppose I am a layman and I have to answer this question, right? Then how will I answer this question? It is written in the question that is a test tube baby, means a baby which is formed in the test tube, right? A baby which is formed in the test tube means outside the human body in the laboratory, right? So a baby is born in IVF. This comes under a IVF category. Students, is this visible to you? This IVF, that is in vitro fertilization. Fertilization outside the human body or in vitro condition inside the laboratory is called as a IVF technology, right? So we are producing some IVF baby, that is a test tube baby, where fertilization is occurring outside the body or in the test tube, right? So what after the fertilization, what we do, we implant the zygote into the woman's body or into the uterus, into the endometrium. We are implanting the zygote into the endometrium so that the child development can occur, right? So first we have is intracytoplasmic sperm injection. No, this could not be the reason, because we have already fertilized the ovum, right? And then we are implanting that fertilized egg into the human body, right? So this could not be the reason, intracytoplasmic sperm injection. In the intracytoplasmic sperm injection, what exactly the case is, if we talk about this in detail, the sperm is injected into the cytoplasm of the egg, right? Because those couple go for this particular procedure when the male is unable to produce the sperm, or the sperm motility is lost by some the male is some diseased and the sperms are immotile, in those cases they go for such procedure that is an intracytoplasmic sperm injection. Next we have is intrauterine insemination. No, this could not be the reason, because we are inseminating, means we are inserting the sperm. There is no need to insert the sperm because we have already produced the whole, we have already produced those things, na? We have already produced the baby in the test tube, right? So next is a gamete intrafallopian transfer. No, this could not be the reason because we have the gametes. That's why we have produced a test tube baby, right? Next we have a zygote intrafallopian transfer. Yes, this is the reason why the zygote is formed in the like test tube baby, means zygote is formed outside the body and that zygote is transplanted into the human body, into the body of the female, or more precisely I can say into the uterus. So zygote intrafallopian transfer, that is called as a ZIFT, Z-I-F-T, zygote intrafallopian transfer is the right answer for this question, students, right? Next we have another question. Question number 8. So, the question number 8 says, ectopic pregnancies are referred to as. Now, students, you should know what do you mean by ectopic pregnancies. Ectopic pregnancy, normally pregnancy occur, fertilization normally occur in the fallopian tube, and later on that fertilized egg, they come to the uterus where the implantation occur, that is in the endometrium, right? So ectopic pregnancies are those pregnancies where fertilization occur in the fallopian tube and the development also occur in the fallopian tube, and such type of ectopic pregnancy are also called as tubal pregnancy. Tubal pregnancy means the fertilization are occur in the tube as well as the whole development is occurring in the tube, that is a tubal pregnancy. Students, actually this is not safe, and ultimately when the child is detected that it is a ectopic, it is to be terminated because it is fatal for mother as well as for the developing baby, right? So the answer are that option number A states that pregnancies with the genetic abnormalities. No, this could not be the case because we are not dealing here with the amniocentesis or chorionic villi sampling, right? Next we have is an implant. This is a wrong option. Next we have an implantation of the embryo at the site of other than uterus. Implantation of embryo at the site other than uterus. Yes, this could be the reason because implantation occurs in the uterus, right? I have told you about ectopic pregnancy is also called as a tubal pregnancy, or the pregnancy where the implantation is occurring in the fallopian tube, that is called as a tubal pregnancy. So it is not occurring in the uterus, it is occurring in fallopian tube, so this could be the reason. So let's talk about this option C, implantation of the defective embryo in the uterus. No, this could not be the reason because we are not dealing any congenital disease over here. We are not dealing with amniocentesis or chorionic villi sampling. So this is not the reason for that. Next is pregnancies terminated due to the hormonal imbalance. Now, this is very irrelevant. So the correct option we have is option B, right? Next we have another question. What is the figure given below showing in particular? So students, can you tell what exactly is this thing? This is a female reproductive system, right? These are the two ovaries, right? These are the fallopian tube where fertilization occurs, right? This is a uterus and this is a female, whole female reproductive part, right? So with this picture, we get to know that this is a female reproductive part, and we can see that somewhere or other some surgical procedure has taken place over here so that the knot is there. Can you see those knot over here? So that means it is that method of contraception where surgery is involved, right? So let's talk about the options first. First we have ovarian cancer. This could be the reason. No, this could not be the reason. Ovarian cancer, how can you correlate ovarian cancer with the surgical procedure? No, you cannot. Next we have is a uterine cancer. No, this is not a reason for that. Next we have is a tubectomy. Yes, this could be the reason because we are cutting the fallopian tube. This is a fallopian tube and we are cutting that and we have rejoined that, and it is at that procedure of contraception. It is a surgical method of contraception where the egg or the ova which is produced over air will not be able to migrate to over the fallopian tube. So there will be no fertilization. The sperm which will be entering into the vagina from here, it will enter into the fallopian tube for fertilization because the passage is blocked. So there will be no fertilization. So answer is tubectomy. Next we have the D option, that is a vasectomy. If you talk about the vasectomy, in this occurs in the male. Students, you need to remember, we are talking about tubectomy. Tubec means we are cutting the tube. What kind of tube? We are cutting the fallopian tube here, right? So these are the fallopian tube. On the both side, we cut these fallopian tubes and we tie those fallopian tube. So next is the vasectomy. Vasectomy is another procedure that a male follows. Vasectomy, can you correlate vasectomy with vas deferens? Yes, we can correlate that. Vasectomy is a cutting of the vasa deferentia so that there will be no transfer of the sperm, so that there will be no fertilization.